for Dan Allstar. Welcome, everybody. Before we begin, may I ask everybody to turn off their cell phones. If children cannot be silent, I would ask that you take them out of the auditorium for the sake of our musicians. And please, no flash photography, and please do not come up to the stage to take pictures. Thank you so much for being here. Please rise for the national anthem. Thank you and welcome to our 2003 Catholic School Honor Band. I'd like to thank Brother Joshua and Brother Shane, St. Anthony High School. I would like to thank Mr. Fisher, who co-directed this event. He was going to share the podium today. He had a family emergency and will not be here this weekend. But my thanks to Mr. Fisher. And also to Mr. Licata, who has been in charge of our drum section and will be sharing the podium as well. To Mrs. Hawes, who's choreographed lots of seats and drums and the many, many things that need to be done. Mr. Cortez for his lower voices and his technical assistance. And Mr. Jay Friedman for his great arrangements. I'd like to thank our two wind ensemble drummers, Jake Green and Monica Maloney. And I'd like to thank my Long Island faculty, Jeff Erdman, Ilya Steinman, Karen Rudiman, Nate Trito, Jennifer Tui, Pat Dalton, Chris Gray, Jeff Cobbs, Keith Prey, Jennifer Terry, Bill Stroud, Lynn Francali, Chris Weigers, Rachel Sedillo, Tracy Tuckwood, Florence Statlander, Katie Pindus, Chris Lesser. And principals, this event is never possible without you. We are all indebted to you. As a parent, I appreciate the sacrifice that we all make. I'd like to just take a moment and thank the people who have driven here from the East End, Cutchogue and Southampton, Santa Mauritius, Sag Harbor. So you folks are real troopers. Thank you. As always, I'm honored by the fact that Sister Joanne, Superintendent of Schools, is here. She's been supporting this event from its inception as a principal and for the last many years as a superintendent. So thank you, Sister, for being here. During the rehearsal last week, while Mr. Fisher was rehearsing the band. I sat back in the audience. And for the first time, I sat back and didn't worry about the drums rushing or the clarinets playing the wrong note or whatever. I sat back and I watched. And I saw these young people. I mean, not the bass drummer or the first clarinet player, but all of the people on the stage, the far end, the people who are having the first year experience with the Honor Band. And I saw them focused and staring at the music, moving their fingers and using their mouth and tapping their feet and watching the conductor. And I thought that this is just a great thing. This just warmed my heart, and I was so proud to be associated with this group. They are disciplined, they are focused, they are talented, and most of all, they are a joy to work with. So how about a tremendous hand for the musicians? In a moment, our drum section is going to depart for a few minutes and the wind ensemble will start. At the conclusion of the performance, please give the musicians about 10 minutes and then meet them at the rear of the building, in the rear breezeway, not in the cafeteria. Thank you so much for being here. I hope you enjoy the show. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. It'll just take a moment to get our drummers on stage, and we'll start out with the 2003 Honor Band. Thank you. It's my pleasure to introduce Mr. Joseph Lakata, who will conduct Oye Como Va. Just to show you, I too can be funky. Thank you so much. It's my pleasure to introduce Sister Joanne Callahan from the Diocese of Rockville Center.
Thank you, Mr. Effman. I thought that this afternoon as I was riding over here that this is now my 18th and soon to be my 19th at 4 o'clock presentation in the last 10 years. And say, well, what happened to the one? I would have had something else at 4 o'clock one Sunday, but I've never done that again, Mr. Effman. Never. I'm delighted to be here this afternoon and certainly to congratulate our young boys and girls for their wonderful, wonderful presentation. You were terrific. And I do say it every year, but it does get better, and it's hard to believe it can. How many of you, this is the first time you've been to the Honors Band program? Aren't you just shocked at what these students have done this afternoon? 58 schools coming together. For a few practices, and this is what can happen. Boys and girls, really, truly, you have given us a wonderful presentation this afternoon. I love music. I've told most of you, if you're new, you don't know this, but I really can't sing and I can't play an instrument. I tried all of it. It didn't work. I tried the drums, couldn't do that. I tried the bugle, imagine that. My parish had a bugle corps when I was growing up. And I thought, oh, this, how bad can it be? And then I switched to the drums, but if you don't have rhythm, you just can't do that either. But I love music. And to think that all of you have done this for us this afternoon, I commend you and congratulate you and thank you. I thank your parents because A, it's above and beyond tuition, and I know that's difficult for many of you. Mr. Effman, I thank completely because without him, our schools would not be able to offer this band program. And really, for these students, it's wonderful. And then, of course, all of you to make those kids practice to really be up here today. Because it does take practice. It does take perseverance, and it does take commitment. Playing an instrument is very difficult. Because you don't always feel like practicing, do you? No. I'll bet there's been some Saturday mornings you didn't even want to come to Honors Band practice, right? But isn't it all worthwhile this afternoon? It is for us. Thank all of you and have a good afternoon.
It'll just be about 10 minutes before the students are ready to meet you. Thank you so much. Have a great spring. Thank you.